I had a haircut. What do you think? For those of you who have watched my channel for some years, you know that I cut my own hair. I have not been in a barbershop since I was 17 years old. The occasion of which was I went to the barbershop and he gave me a terrible haircut, and I said, I think I can do this better myself. So all of these years I have. That's another video. Today I thought I'd talk about the news. The news here in Ajijic, Mexico. But let's start with the weather. Hey Google, what's the weather?
Currently in Ajijic, it's 63 degrees with light showers. Today, there'll be thunderstorms with a forecasted high of 68 and a low of 62.
Hey Google, what's the weather in Salome, Arizona?
Currently in Salome, it's 95 degrees and sunny. Today, it'll be mostly sunny, with a forecasted high of 104 and a low of 81. There is currently an excessive heat warning in effect.
That's where our motorhome is. We're happy to be here. It's a cool, rainy day here, unusually so, on the north shore of Lake Chapala in Ajijic, Jalisco, Mexico. Let's go outside and take a look at the weather. Sixty-four degrees. That thing's really growing. Everything looks more vivid in the rain. Look at this over here. Oh, I'm getting my feet wet. That's okay. My new patio, I don't know if I ever showed you the new tile work we did on the patio. White caps on the lake. Can't see across the lake. Looks like being on the ocean. I'm sure the wind is terrible in my camera right now. Go back in the house and see what we're going to talk about today. No sun for the butterfly. What are you going to do today, Lynn? Color?
Yeah.
What are you coloring?
Flowers.
Flowers?
Yeah.
You should color sunflowers and pretend it's sunny.
These are as close to sunflowers as I can get. The zinnias.
You have enough pencils?
I have some other new ones that I haven't opened up. Don't
want to
run out.
Let me see some more of your pictures. What kind of flower is that? Petunia?
Pansy.
Pansy. What else you got here? Oh, a rose?
Uh-huh, the orange rose.
It says down here, yellow rose. What color is that?
That's orange. Well, there was a yellow one on this page. I didn't...
Trumpet daffodil. Okay, what else you got?
Oh, that is very colorful.
Buttercup. Butter color.
See, these have red around the yellow.
Well, that's more colorful.
Yep.
What's this? Magnolia. That grows in a tree, right?
Magnolia. Big
iris.
Bush.
Iris. Iris, remember the iris stained glass we did for the big White House?
Yeah, I do remember it.
The big White House. You guys know about the big White House? That's the house we lived in Portland, Oregon. 7,000 square foot. National Historical Register. That's when our daughter, who's in her 40s now, fell down and smashed her face. Took a header off of her Pluto big wheel. This stuff up here, that's just deterioration in the old picture. But
she's in her 40s.
Here's Lynn and Jerry and their two little kids. They're both in their 40s. And Lynn and Jerry are a little older. That was one of our first boats. Son Peter caught the biggest fish. What else we got going here? Kids on their horse. Lynn and Jerry, younger. What a beauty. Oh, Popeye. Some of our many, many cats we've had throughout the years. Well, anyway, hello.
You can show him a picture of my mother with a fish.
Where's your mother with a fish?
On the bottom, a round one.
Oh, there, Lynn's mother caught a, what kind of fish was
perch.
It? A perch. Yeah. Anyway.
And look over there.
What?
That one in the corner.
Right here?
Yeah, you and Peter are fishing.
I already showed that one.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, he's happy. I'm sad because he had the bigger fish. Yeah, porch swing, two kids in the porch swing. Well, anyway.
Well, back to my coloring.
And I'm back to seeing what I'm going to talk about in a video today. Please enjoy my stories or whatever else might be on my mind today. So, what's in the news today? Well, are you just kind of tired of hearing about Afghanistan and the COVID? I am. I'm getting to the point where I'm fast-forwarding past those stories. I watch a lot of news on my iPad, and once you start watching that kind of stuff, you just get the same, more the same, more the same, more the same all the time. I'm sure you're probably aware of this, but if you're interested in one particular story, then the algorithms of YouTube or Facebook or Instagram, they'll just keep sending you the same kind of stuff, which reinforces your idea about how the world works, your political position, your idea about what's going on in the West with drought, the weather. Whatever you watch, you'll get more of the same. So be careful what you watch. And be vigilant with your mind. It's awfully easy for stuff to get in there. It's awfully hard sometimes to get it out. Anyway, the news. We're looking at the Guadalajara Reporter, English language newspaper. It comes out once a week here on Fridays in Ajijic. And as I was saying, Mexico welcomes the first Afghan refugees. Sounds like we got lucky. We got a whole team of women robotics experts. Quick guide to bagging a Mexican vaccination certificate. People are having trouble getting a certificate to prove that they've been vaccinated here in Mexico. Lynn and I aren't worried about that particular thing because we have vaccination cards from a clinic in Nogales, Arizona. The hospital was also nice enough to print out an actual letter certifying that we got both of our Moderna shots. So we not only have that little card, which I've laminated just in case you got to show it somewhere, we also have a letter that says it's a real card, because apparently there's some problem with people now forging those cards with fake cards, counterfeit cards. That's the word I'm looking for. So anyway, enough about that. You know, what's going on in Afghanistan, I'm sympathetic, but it's not really affecting my daily life. It's so easy to get all wound up about things that have nothing to do with what's going on in your life. It only has something to do with what's going on in the world at large. And you can be sympathetic, but don't get all wound up about it. You know, what's going on in the world politically, or what's going on in the world, you know, with wars, or what's going on in the world with a whole bunch of things, you know, famine, hurricanes, they're not really affecting me. Maybe the weather is a little bit today, because the rainy day we're having is due to a hurricane that's in the Pacific off of the western coast of Mexico, and it's going to be approaching Puerto Vallarta, which is 200 kilometers that way. That's what we're getting here. So, is it affecting my life? No. What really is affecting my life is yesterday I made cinnamon rolls. That's what's affecting my life today. The news. Back to the news. Murder of Chapala expat adds to spike in crime. You know, it's the nature of news that it's something that is unusual. The things that happen every day aren't news. Only the things that are unusual are newsworthy. So take this crime wave with a grain of salt. Even newspapers have to make something important. But I'm going to read you the article because it is important. To know what's going on around you when you are living a retired life in Mexico. Murder of Chapala expat adds to spike in crime. Well, once again, I've forgotten how old I am and how dirty my glasses are. An elderly man, tentatively identified as a U.S. citizen in his 70s, was found dead in his Chapala home on Sunday, August 22nd. That'd be 2021. The apparent victim of a homicide. The crime occurred at a downtown address on Calle Juarez. The corpse was discovered lying face down in a bed with his hands bound together behind his back. While the murder investigation is underway, official statistics indicate a recent spike in the Lakeside area's crime index. Data released this week on criminal complaints lodged during July put Chapala and Jocotepec near the top of the list for 10 municipalities located outside the Guadalajara metro area, surpassed only by Puerto Vallarta. Chapala authorities registered 76 new criminal cases last month at a rate of 13.7 crimes for every 10,000 inhabitants. For the same number of people, Puerto Vallarta chalked up 479 complaints, registering 15.8 crimes for 10,000 residents. The most common crimes were home burglaries and auto theft. And that's why I drive 20-year-old vehicles. Go ahead and steal them. See if it's worth your time. You know, there's a lot of advertisements in the paper all the time, and you kind of break them down mostly into three things: real estate, restaurants, and travel. Here's one that's for a restaurant. I'm not going to name the restaurant because I'm not going to say a nice thing about them. It's advertising the month of September as Independence Month. It's actually September 16th is Independence Day in Mexico, and restaurants have special meals. They have special meals for Easter, they have special meals for Christmas, they have special meals for a lot of things. I used to have a calendar with all of the holidays for Mexico on it, and there were only 2 days of the year that weren't attributed to something. Most of it patron saints of little towns. Anyway, I don't go out to special dinners on special days, and here's why. It's always higher price, and they have a greater clientele on those days, so the quality of the food goes down a little bit, I think, and the service, because they're busier, is not up to its usual standards. So I don't go out on special days for a restaurant meal because it's higher price, lower quality, worse service. That's my reasoning. And I'm not just telling you a theory. I've tested this for years. So anyway, that's why I didn't say the name of the restaurant. But yeah, 280 pesos for a special meal. And a special meal any other day of the week is probably around 1,000 pesos less. Here's a meat market. People wonder about getting meat. There's this thing in Mexico that it's very difficult to get used to, and even after all these years here, I still find it somewhat perplexing and occasionally annoying. Mexican meat places don't cut meat the same way they do in the United States, so although I can go to Walmart and I can get a New York strip or a ribeye, I'm paying exorbitant prices for it because it's cut differently than what most Mexican stores, most Mexican meat cutters, different cuts. Like, have you ever heard of a steak in the United States called Bacio? That's V-A-C-I-O. Literal translation is empty, which doesn't make any sense to me, but you never heard of a Bacio steak in the United States. But I picked this to talk about because it says USDA meats. And since the name of my channel is JC Travel Stories, I'll tell you a travel story from 50 years ago. 50 years ago, Lynn and I used to go down to a little 20-foot camper trailer on the beach in Rosarita Beach, Baja, California. That's Mexico, south of Tijuana, north of Ensenada, on the Pacific coast. And a friend owned that trailer, and it was just on the beach down there, and we'd go down there and stay. But he was a friend, he was friends with the local sheriff. And the local sheriff used to sell us New York steaks out the back door at night of the carniceria, the meat market, and stamped in the fat of the meat, it said USDA choice. We always thought, the price was really good. We always thought it must have been cows that got too close to the border. Anyway, USDA Meats is the name of a meat market here in Ajijic, and they have black Angus, pork, lamb, frog legs, duck, venison, barbecue ribs, seafood, fish, rabbit, and Sonora steaks. And I laugh at Sonora steaks because being here 20 years, I have observed that the terms for a good steak come and go. So sometimes it's Sonoran, oh, these steaks are Sonoran steaks. And then sometimes it's, oh, these are Chihuahuan steaks. Or, oh, this is from Argentina, this meat. It's different buzzwords that come and go. So I guess right now it must be Sonoran steaks. Sonora is and Chihuahua are states in Mexico. What else going on in the paper here? Oh, well, we're talking about negative news. Missing men located in Chapala. Four young men who were officially listed as missing persons were located by Jalisco authorities on August 18th at a rehab center for addiction. So they've disappeared from their family for a reason. Free COVID tests in Chapala and Jacotepec. Well, we're back to talking about the COVID again. It is something that has affected all of our lives in different ways. Chapala and Jacotepec were among 12 municipalities in the interior of the state where Jalisco's Ministry of Health sent personnel this week to offer free tests for the COVID. And although complete results were not available at press time, it was reported that approximately 25% of the first 100 tests applied in Jacotepec came out positive. That's kind of scary. The incidence of infection was minimal during the early hours of testing in Chapala, according to the municipality's medical director. Ay, ay, ay. Yeah, the COVID. We're looking forward to getting in motorhome and being out and away from crowds. Although I do spend time with people I know in Arizona, in our motorhome. We're always outside. We're never indoors and never in really big crowds. Oh, and again, speaking of the COVID, I mean, what else are we going to talk about? Patriotic festivities canceled. Following health protection measures decreed by state authorities, the Chapala government has canceled patriotic festivals traditionally scheduled during the month of September. So that means that the customary September 13 Niños Héroes and September 15 Grito de la Independencia commemorations have been called off. And I can tell you that all of the cats and dogs are cheering because they hate the fireworks. Speaking of fireworks, I'm tired today. And I'm tired today because somewhere in this neighborhood, about 1 o'clock, music started, and I can't actually hear the music. I can only hear the bass. Boom, 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 boom. This is something that happens in Mexico a lot. And that started at 1 o'clock. It was so loud that it woke me up, and I got up, had a bowl of cereal, watched a couple of YouTube videos, and by 2:30, a big fireworks thing took off. Boom, 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 boom. Lights in the sky. And then it seemed to quiet down. And I went back to bed. It woke me up again around 3:30. It went on. Today is Saturday. That was Friday night. It is now about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And it's still going on. It's not as loud as it was. But I'd still hear it. Boom, 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 boom. Bienvenidos de Mexico. Thanks for spending time with me today. Hey, if you like me, give me one of those thumbs up. And please subscribe and hit that little bell so you know when I post next. Please share me with your friends on social media. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed what was on my mind today.